For the Bible lets us know in 1 Timothy chapter 1 verse 7, for God has not given us a spirit of fear, but of power and of love and of a sound mind. So when those transitions comes in our lives, we must just stand still and see the salvation of the Lord. Yes, David was in a harmful situation, but it doesn't matter when we're in those harmful situations. We have to know that there's some blessed help on the inside of us as God's children, that we just stand still and see his salvation. We'll be able to know what direction that God would give us for the next move in our lives. So here David moves from one environment to another environment, and he goes with a little fear. And as he gets there, Abimelech begins to taunt him and laugh at him. Because this is David, the warrior king. David, in your battles, we heard your songs, we heard the stories where Saul killed 1,000 and you killed 10,000. David, is this you, David? The man who had all power in his head. Now you're on the run. You don't have the same confidence that you had when you were in your earlier battles. And sometimes in life, as we begin to grow up and we make those adjustments, what happened on yesterday holds us till this moment, but we don't know what tomorrow may bring. And sometimes when we don't know what tomorrow is going to bring, we hold on to our yesterday, but sometimes the humanness in who we are, sometimes there's moments of fear and doubt and concern on this Christian journey. So here he goes to Abimelech, and Abimelech begins to laugh at him and taunt him. And have you ever had those moments when you had to leave in a certain environment and to go to somebody else where you thought you were going to get help and encouragement in the midst of your difficult time, but you found yourself when you left where you were and went where you were going, where you left from was a lot better than where you were going, and you regretted that you left where you were and you hope to go back where you were. Well, David was like that in this situation. He left Saul under the spear in the moment, but he goes to one of his enemies. And Abimelech begins to taunt him and laugh at him. Aren't you David that killed all of those Philistines? Aren't you David who killed Goliath, the giant who's over 9 feet tall? And I don't know how tall David was. Maybe he was my height or somewhere in between. Look at that. You know, like me beating up Shaquille O'Neal. I thought it out there. I have blessings of heaven, but David is hearing all these words that's opposite of what God's word has to say. So we have to be very careful that when we move on this Christian journey, we have to make sure that when we leave certain places or seek counsel for somebody, we best make sure that person knows the Lord in a personal relationship for ourselves. How many of us have gone to somebody else to somewhere in life and they gave us a bitter piece of information, and that bitter information that they gave us just wrecked our whole lives? We have to understand that when we make these moves, adjustments in life, we have to know that the Lord is always there with us. So here David is hearing all of these words of discouragement. He's already in a bad situation, but he goes somewhere and it gets just a little bit worse. For 1 Samuel 21, verses 11 through 15, and the servants of Ashkai said unto him, is not this David the king of the land? You're in the position of the Lord, and you have power over everything, and you have power over everyone. Is this David who's sitting on the throne? Now you're on the one. He said, did they not sing one another of him, his songs and dances? Saul had slain his thousands, and David his 10,000, and David laid upon the words in his heart. And as David heard these words, he's remembering where he used to be. He's remembering how God had took care of him, even in the middle of some of those battles that he was dealing, working with Saul. But now he's hearing these discouraging moments of words. And we're living in times where the world, morally and spiritually, is just falling apart. We look around and see what's going on, the tragedy that happened in France a couple of weeks ago. And just a couple of days, somewhere else, ISIS had attacked and killed some individuals. And we as believers, we're seeing all of these things that's going on around us. And yes, we may not understand, but yes, to a certain extent, these things do affect us. Now, international travels, if we've been going anywhere internationally, have been cut. We may wanted to go to Israel. We may wanted to go to Africa. We may wanted to go to some places in the world. But now, because of what happened way over there, it's affecting us in our daily living. Government have to beef up its security, even in the airports, in the grocery markets, and even on our jobs, where we're a little bit more vigilant to be aware of what's going on around us. So David is in this situation to where he has to realize that in the midst of his fear and his moment, he has to remember that he has some blessed help on the inside, that where he's at in his present state, just because he's in that place, it doesn't mean it has to affect him in his walk and his relationship with God. And even though we're living in times that things are difficult and hard in our private and in our personal lives, we have to understand that despite what goes on outside, it does not have to affect us on the inside, because if we lean not to our own understanding,
that's right,
but in all of our ways acknowledge him, we can stand in the midst of the fiery trials of the devil and stand still and see the salvation of the Lord. So here David, as he begins to contemplate and remember what God has done for us, so in the midst of our struggles and on our runs and our stands and our uprising and our sit down, we just have to sit down sometime and just have a shout out and talk with God.
Yeah.
You have somebody and you can just go to and cast all your cares upon him. Because see, when you know God for yourself, you have those moments of protocols, and there's protocols in prayer. But when David, Peter was sinking on the water, he didn't have time for protocols.
I know that's right.
God, I need the help. I'm going through some difficulties. You know my storm. You know my aches and pain. And that's how he is going to do it. We just have to know how to talk to him. So David begins to remember that in the midst of hearing these negative words, he's also remembering that there's somebody on the inside that's reminding him that if you just hold on to what I've given you, if you just hold on to the word that I've placed in you, that when those things arise, you'll still be able to bless the Lord at all times. Blessing the Lord, like David lets us know, that in the midst of our circumstances, it's a choice. Even in the midst of stuff that's going on, we still have a choice,
right,
to choose whether we're going to murmur or complain.
Right.
Praise the Lord.
That's right.
So why is that? Because even in the midst of our hurt, even in the midst,
hey,
of our hurt and our pain, the fact that we're still standing when others thought we were not going to be able to stand, and enough shout to tell Lord. David is not thinking about nobody else, but he's remembering what God has done for him. And when we think about what God has done for us in the midst of our circumstances, we can bless him. We can tell him thank you. Why? Because in the midst of all of our steps and every breath that we breathe, our hurts and our pains, our stands and our falls, God is right there with us. Though our days ago, I was at work and had a vehicle accident where somebody shredded
And ever since then, you know, when you get over 5 years old, your bones and your body just don't have to
say. He said 5 years old. 5 years old.
So ever since then.
5 years old.
My body's aching. Mornings I wake up, sometimes I'm doing well, and sometimes I'm not doing so well. And sometimes when you have those accidents, not only do your body, your flesh gets in it, but the bones.
Yeah, yeah.
And your nerves.
Yeah.
And your muscles.
Yeah.
All that stuff going on. But despite what occurred a couple of days ago, God already knew I was coming down the avenue of that street. Even before Mama and Daddy got together, He knew I was coming that direction. And when I gave my life to Him, I was living on borrowed account. So when I sleep where I was, the Lord was right there. I said, so I'm saying I bless the Lord at all times. So I got home later on and I thought about what could have happened. So we got to understand even in what could have happened. God could have let some stuff happen. I could have went into a building. I wouldn't be here right now. To let you know that in your circumstances, you can bless the Lord at all times. But then he says, I choose to bless Him. To pray, bless Him. And when we know God for ourselves, we can just bless Him. Now, blessing is not just saying the word bless. Oh, I'm blessed and highly favored. Yeah, but I'm looking at your actions a little bit later on to see if you still blessed or favored, highly favored. But blessed is how we react and respond to the circumstances that's contrary of Him being blessed. So just saying the word, oh, I'm blessed, there's something else you got to put up on in there. You got to know that when trials happen in our lives and hurts and pains come in our lives, how we know God is really blessed is how we respond His way in the midst of the circumstances. So here James says, even though I'm out of this situation, even though I'm out of that environment, David says, I'm going to bless that in what has come around like a Abimelech and all, I'm going to still say that the Lord is worthy to be praised. Because why? He sustained me in the midst of all of my difficulties. He's holding me and keeping me. When the enemies come upon me to eat in my flesh like a flood, they stone me. Why? Because the Lord is holding me. David says, I will bless. So he chooses to praise Him. Then he praises Him. He says, I will bless the Lord at all times. All times mean you first got to have a time from Him. You can't have plural with singular. Before you go plural, you got to have a singular. Singular means one. Spanish is uno. And you got to have a uno before you have a plural. Before you can get more of being able to bless Him, you got to know Him first of all as your personal Lord and Savior. That's the greatest blessing that I know of anything that can happen to anybody. So now that David knows that he's saved, every time after time. Did you get that? 1 o'clock, 2 o'clock, 2 o'clock, 3 o'clock. You can't get three without the one, and two's waiting on one. Three can't rush two, and five can't rush one, because one, you got to have one to get them all. So he sits there and says, I will bless the Lord at all times. Lord and Savior. I will bless, I will praise Him that in my circumstances I can choose to either murmur or complain, but I will say thank you, Lord, because if it had not been for the Lord on my side, I wouldn't be here. David said this morning, he said, so I choose to bless Him. And when I bless Him, I'm going to respond to my circumstances because He's worthy. Now created the heaven and the earth. Genesis chapter 1, verse 10, and the Lord called the dry land earth, and the gathering together of the waters called he seed. And God saw that it was good. Genesis chapter 1, verse 12, and the Lord brought forth grass and herb yielding seed after his kind, and the tree yielding fruit whose seed is in itself after his kind. And God saw that it was good. Genesis 1 and 18, and the roll covered the days and over the night, and to the divide the light from the darkness. And God saw that it was good, his praise. Genesis 1 and 21, and God created great whales and every living thing that moved with the water, brought forth abundance after their kind, and every winged fowl after his kind. And God saw that it was good. Genesis 1 and 25, and God made the beasts of the earth after his kind, and the cattle after their kind, and everything that creepeth upon the earth after his kind. And God saw that it was good. Genesis 1 and 31, and God saw everything that he had made, and behold, it was very good. And every evening and the morning was the sixth day. So David is operating on something that's not his. He's operating on the word of God. And when we keep that helping hand on the inside, though we walk through the valley of the shadow of death, it's not us doing the shouting. It's God on the inside motivating us to hold to his unchanging land. So David says, I will bless the Lord at all times. His praise shall continually be in my mouth. Why? Because I have the blessing. I have the happiness. I have the hope. I have somebody who's on the inside. And even in the midst of my circumstances, when they're contrary to what God said, David said, I can still choose to praise his name. So in the midst of what's going on around us and what's going on the inside, we can still choose to praise his name. Why? Because we have in there camp. We have in there inside hope. We have in there ARP. We have inside Kaiser. We have in there all these hurts. We have them on the inside. And we just trust and lean not to our own understanding, but in all our ways acknowledge him. And he shall direct our path. So you need to know that when you go through what you're going through, you're not going through it all by yourself. We have somebody, not an it or a thing or a feeling. We have the person of the living God, the creator, who abides, rules within us. And if we just listen to him, we can be happy in the midst of our circumstances. And as I get ready to close, notice when God created everything, and even in David's situation, you didn't see no hands. You didn't see actual hands, like hands of a person telling you, oh, everything is going to be all right. But God's hand, he's spirit. And they that worship him must worship him in spirit and in truth. He's on the inside of us. And if we rely upon him with his word, he will make us happy even in the middle of our difficulty. So David says, I will choose to praise his name in my circumstances because the praise that had been given to me are not my own. I remember when I didn't have anything, but I came to Jesus just as I was, weary, wounded, and sad, and I found in him a resting place, and he has made me glad. Now he deposited in me